क्लास सिक्स सोशल साइंस ज्योग्राफी लेसन वन अर्थ इन द सोलर सिस्टम पार्ट थ्री। नाउ एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट दिस इज द फिगर और दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ अवर सोलर सिस्टम। फ्रॉम दिस डायग्राम यू सी दैट देयर इज अ सन दैट इज अ स्टैटिक बॉडी एंड अ स्टार। ओके एंड दीज आर द प्लैनेट्स रिवॉल्विंग राउंड द सन। दिस इज अवर सोलर सिस्टम। सन, एट प्लैनेट्स, asteroids, with asteroids makes a solar system. Now today we are going to discuss about the sun. Sun, in according to Roman mythology, soul is the sun god. Solar means related to the sun. Whenever you use the term solar, it means it is related to the sun, and the family of sun is therefore called solar system. That is why the family of sun is also known as solar system, because the word meaning of the solar is related to the sun, because the solar word means related to the sun. That's why all the members of the sun family are included in the solar system. Now the sun is in the center of the solar system. As already you see that in this figure, the sun is here. Sun is the head of our solar system, and it is a static celestial body, not the moving celestial body like the planets and asteroids. Okay, sun is a static body in the solar system. It is a huge and made up of extremely hot gases. Now from this line we are going to know that it is clear to all of you that the sun is the ball of burning hot gases. It provides the pulling force that binds the solar system, like the earth has a gravitational force, same like that a sun also has a pulling force that binds the solar system. The sun is the ultimate source of heat and light for the solar system, and for our solar system our planet Earth and other planets get its heat and light from the sun, because only the sun is the main source of heat and light for our solar system. It is as already told you that sun is the ball of extremely hot gases, or sun is made up of hot gases. That's why it gives us heat and light, but that tremendous heat is not felt so much by us, but we are not able to feel its tremendous heat, because we have, despite being our nearest star, it is far away from us. Sun is also our nearest star, but the distance between the sun and the earth is 150 million kilometers. That is suitable for earth. That makes the earth's temperature comfortable for the living beings. That means the distance between the sun and the earth is 150 million kilometers. That provides the earth suitable temperature, heat and light from the sun, which gives a proper living organism, or due to which the living organism are able to live on the earth or survive on the earth. So this is about the sun. Now our next topic is planets. As already you told you that there are 8 planets in our solar system. They are arranged in a particular manner in our solar system. Sun is the static body of the solar system. First planet is Mercury, then Venus, then Earth, then Mars, then Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. To learn this, the order of the planets, there is a simple sentence given to all of us. My very efficient mother just served us nuts. From this sentence, the first word of sentence gives or denotes the name of the planet. M means Mercury, V means Venus, E means Earth, another M means Mars, J means Jupiter, S means Saturn, U means Uranus and N means Neptune. So it is very easy for all of you when you learn this sentence. My very efficient mother just served us nuts. Due to this sentence, or with the help of this sentence, you are able to learn the name of the planets according to their numbers arranged in the solar system. Now, as all I already told you that these planets are revolving round a sun. These planets are moving or revolving round the sun in a particular path. This white line shows the path of the planets, and this elliptical part of the planet is known as orbit. In this path, the planets are moving around the sun. So this path is known as orbit. Now, Mercury is the nearest to the sun. So it takes 88 days to complete one round. As already you know that the Earth takes 365 days to complete the one revolution around the sun. So like that, Mercury is the nearest planet. So it takes only 88 days to complete the one round around the sun in its own orbit. Venus is considered as Earth twins, and the second number planet Venus is considered as the twin of Earth because its shape and size is somewhat similar to the Earth. Why? Now the question is, why the Venus is considered an Earth twins? Because the Venus has its shape and size very much similar to the Earth. Now next, till recently Pluto. Now I want to tell you that the Pluto is also the one of the planet in our solar system, but now from 2006 the Pluto was known as a dwarf planet because geologists thought, Astronomical Union, International Astronomical Union decided that Pluto, like other objects discovered in recent past, may be called dwarf planet because now the Pluto, we are not able to see Pluto in a particular orbit revolving around the sun. That's why the International Astronomical Union considered it as a dwarf planet.